Well, hello once again, Derby fans and addicts, wherever you may be. I am Mike Checks alongside Double H, and you are watching the 2016 Wftda International Division I Playoffs live from Vancouver, British Columbia, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Terminal City Rollergirls.
Welcome. Welcome, Mike Checks.
Thank you.
It's good to be here.
Indeed.
We're going to take a look at some of the rosters right now, and we're going to start with a lower seed, which is Terminal City. They came into this tournament number 5 in the seeding, as you mentioned. It's number 1111, make that 1111, Sundown. Number 1223, Kim Janna. Number 131, Brewsberry Pie. Number 16, Palmer. Number 22, your new favorite name, Moulin Brews.
That's right.
Number 31, Eve Hallows. Number 314, Bazinga. Number 42, Griffith. Number 44, Scarlet Bloodbath. Number 5, Inkshot. Number 69, Flower Plower. Number 86, Drago. Number 88, Maiden Sane. And number 90, Green Machine.
And their opponents, the Philly Roller Girls, number 13 in the Wftda, fourth seed in this tournament. Skating for them in this game, number 00, Meryl Stripper. 06, Michelle Castro. Number 15, Kill Martin. 152 is Herman Monster. 1915, Zip Block. Number 247, Devoid of Mercy. 434, Wolf. 45, Built to Spill. 66, Little Loca. Number 80, Papa Roach. Number 85, Teflon Donna. Number 87, Volturine de Slayer. Number 957, Ginger Vitus. And rounding out the team, number 99, Russian Bayou.
So Philly coming into this tournament, the number 4 seed, Terminal City, the number 5. Mike Checks, the only number 5 seed to overthrow a number 4 was in Lansing so far this tournament season. That was Calgary over Cincinnati. So, but Terminal City, home team favorite.
That's what I was going to say. Unfortunately for them, they were not
exactly
the host team. So
not this year.
That's right. Possibly next time.
So definitely ready. All of the skaters are ready, even though the officials aren't entirely ready. So let's take a look at the lineups as they come out here. On the fast girl start line, we've got Kill Martin, number 15 for Philly. And for Terminal, we've got Maiden Sane, number 88.
Blocker contingents in Jam 1. Built to Spill, Little Loca, Papa Roach, and Teflon Donna for Philly. For Terminal, that's going to be Sundown, Palmer, Eve Hollows, and Griffith.
Hometown crowd chanting already. Nice contingent of fans on the far straightaway. Oh. And that was
everybody was ready.
Kill Martin was a little too excited about that.
Well.
That's all right. That is the whistle to start the jam. And Kill Martin is out first, lead jammer status for Philly. About 20 feet behind her, though, Maiden Sane.
Quick start to this bout. Pack accelerating through turn 2 right now as jammer's approaching.
Philly congregating up in the front. Kill Martin trying to grab a point as she calls it off, turning backwards, and she is not able to pick up any points right there. No, one. She gets one, Mike Check. So Philly 1, Terminal City nothing as we end our first jam.
Quick start to this bout. Philly jumping out to an early 1-0 lead.
And Philly in the black with aqua accents. Terminal City in the red, and you may notice the Canadian maple leaves on their pants.
Herman Monster jamming for Philly opposite Moulin Brews.
Terminal City does have the jammer line bench. They're lining up in the back. Herman Monster looking for some room on the inside, finds it. Lead jammer status, Philly. Moulin Brews getting taken to the inside at turn 1 by Castro and Meryl Stripper, and recycled, coming to the sad place with Russian Bayou as a tripod. And now on a scoring run is Monster pushing forward. She's got one to beat. She's able to do so fairly quickly, Mike Checks.
Yes, indeed. Pack got stretched out there between the first apex and second straightaway. That allowed Moulin Brews to take advantage. She's clear on the initial.
First penalty of the game goes to Ginger Vitus of Philly, who is going to sit as her sister Herman Monster calls the jam.
That'll run our score to 9-0 in favor of Philly. Just a minute and 40 seconds taken off the period clock. In the next jam, it appears as though we will have Wolf jamming for Philly. opposite Kim Jenna.
It appears correctly, Mike checks. The appearance you have is correct.
It is nice we have video confirmation of
it's
that.
It's true that we do.
Yeah.
So the pack advantage does go to Terminal City off the line. Getting recycled to the outside, though. Kim Jenna, not able to find some room, looks to move to the inside, comes up against Roach and Loka and Teflon Donna, who recycles her to the infield.
She was 1 foot away from picking up lead jammer status there. Unfortunately, gets recycled to the back, but does pick it up, exiting the pack. Lead jammer going to Terminal City.
And the pack pushes forward and splits around the far straightaway. Wolf is going to get through. She's about half a track behind Kim Jenna. Kim Jenna coming in on a scoring run on the far straightaway. Passes all of the blockers she needs to grab points. Wolf is on a scoring pass as well. Finds some ground on the inside, then gets recycled.
Griffith to the penalty box for Terminal City.
Kim Jan is going to let it go. Her bench telling her to go, go, go. Wolf still trying to work on this tripod that's now a two-person brace. And she's recycled to the outfield.
I like that the coaches for Terminal City chose to trust the blockers there and let their jammer continue to push this jam, rewarded with another 5 points in our first tie, 9 apiece.
So a 4-on-3 pack advantage right now for Philly, and out of the box comes the fourth blocker for Terminal City. Both jammers on a scoring run. Teflon Donna taking Kim Jenna to the outfield at turn one. Nice offense here from Sundown, the pivot from Terminal City as well. And she's able to reform the pack. Ginger Vitus playing some offense at the back for her jammer Wolf, but Kim Jenna, 5 more points for Terminal.
Kim Jenna really had to fight to end that scoring pass there. Was successful, obviously.
14 seconds left in the jam. Kim Jenna, a little apex hop on the inside, and she's going to get through for 5 more points. This is a 19-point jam thus far for her, Mike checks.
Terminal City really locking down the defense in this jam, something they weren't able to do the first couple of jams. And you can hear the roar of approval from the crowd on that 19-4 jam in favor of Terminal City. They lead by 6 early. And fans, we'd like to thank S1 Helmets. S1 Pro Knee Pad, stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption makes the S1 Pro Knee Pad built for roller derby. Find out more at s1helmets.com.
On the Fast Girls start line for Philly Kilmartin, for Terminal City, Drago. The pack completely mixed. Kilmartin trying to find some room on the outside. Gets recycled to the outfield at turn one and brought all the way back to the jammer line. Nice recycling here from Terminal City.
It was a nice job by Inkshot keeping both portions of the pack in play before it reconstricted behind the pivot line.
Kilmartin finally through to become lead jammer for Philly. Drago recycled all the way back to the jammer line now, and a full contingent of blockers from Philly for her to deal with. Persephone attempts an apex jump, a.k.a. Kilmartin. You may remember her as Persephone.
Inkshot reporting to the penalty box for Terminal City.
And now the helmet cover coming off of Drago, Mike checks, as she is held in the sad place by Philly's blockers at turn one.
Unfortunately, her and Scarlet bloodbath quite a bit apart at the time.
And so now Drago's able to make it through. She convinced everyone she was not the jammer holding it in her hand, but the stash got her through. Kilmartin on another scoring run on the near straightaway, looking for some help from her teammates on the outside. She's going to grab a point or two and call it.
And it looks like she got 3, actually. Nice job offense there, helping her pick up that last point. 12-0 jam in favor of Philly as the pendulum swings opposite. It's Philly up by 6. Under 24 minutes left in the first half. Maiden Sane lined up on the jam line for Terminal City opposite Herman Monster.
Philly taking the back line. I don't even know if I could call that a line. It's like two cubes folded into one another, but Terminal City in the front. Maiden Sane trying to find some space on the outside, finds it. Lead jammer status, Terminal City. Meanwhile, Herman Monster able to make it through half a track behind Maiden Sane, who's coming in on a scoring run at turn two, coming in hot. And she is able to get some points before she calls it. Herman Monster, not able to get any, so that's a 3-0 jam in Terminal's favor.
I really did think Herman Monster, the way she was accelerating there, was going to pick off at least 1 point. Apparently the whistle's a little faster than her skates were and held scoreless.
Isn't that always the way, Mike checks?
It seems like it. We got Wolf out on the jam line for Philly opposite Moulin Bruise.
That's the battle of the non-lead jammer.
Yeah.
A sad, slow ballad. All right. In the back is Philly. Offense in the middle is Ginger Vitus, the pivot for Philly. Wolf, the jammer, of course, brought all the way back to turn four. Now the jammers advance again on the near straightaway. Wolf's got one to beat. Lead jammer status goes to her. And your favorite name, Mike checks, Moulin Bruise, removing the star. A star pass successful to the pivot.
That is Scarlet Bloodbath exiting the pack, clear on the initial for Terminal City.
So Wolf is going to call it on the outside, not allowing her opponent to score any points. And 3 points go to her, so Philly now 28, Terminal City 22.
Doubling their lead on the heels of that last jam. 22 minutes left on the period clock, and we would like to thank Radar. The new Radar Halo wheel. Achieve world-class edging without sacrificing grip. Thank you, Radar.
Number 15, Kill Martin. Jamming against number 1223, Kim Janna. So the back line moving to meet Kim Janna. They're not able to hold her, though. She's around the outside. Teflon Donna moves to meet her, is not able to stop her. Lead jammer status goes to Terminal City, but right behind her, a hop through the inside, and Kill Martin's about 20 foot behind.
Palmer tried to take out Kill Martin with a last ditch effort, could not land the hit.
Kim Janna coming in hot to the back of Little Loca. There's going to be a penalty on that, and it is a forearm going to Little Loca. It's kind of an interesting penalty on that.
Agreed. At 1 point brings Terminal City back to within 5. Just under 21 minutes left in the first half. We will see Herman Monster out on the jam line once again for Philly opposite Bazinga for Terminal City.
Terminal City on the back line with the pack advantage. They are 4-3. The pack moving very slowly. Penalties being assessed. There's a direction of gameplay call being assessed to the jammer Bazinga for Terminal City.
That is a rare jammer penalty that you see assigned like that, but
I don't know if I've seen it in the playoffs yet.
That's fair.
Herman Monster has yet to break the pack. She's got two to beat on the far straightaway. Now one pushing forward. An out-of-play call being assessed, but the pack reforming around her. Nice job from Terminal City here. Herman Monster, lead jammer.
Green Machine and Inkshot playing the defense up front. Russian Bayou to the penalty box for Philly.
The pack on the far straightaway. Herman Monster coming in hot to the back. And she's not going to get any kind of back-blocking penalty, so that was nice and clean. She is going to get recycled to the outside, though, by Terminal City, and she's going to slowly take her time finding a way back in. And now she tries the inside. Go ahead, checks.
Bazinga, who has returned to play, knocked to the outside, comes back in, clears on the initial pass for Terminal City.
Herman Monster, not quite sure how many points she picked up, I think, at that moment, decided to call it. She had 5, so 5-0 jam for Philly.
33-23 in favor of Philly. Less than 19 and a half minutes left in the first half. Philly going to send out number 434, Wolf, to the jam line, opposite number 88, Maiden Sane, from Terminal City.
Allison on Twitter says, after all these blowouts, a back-and-forth close game is so stressful.
That is a true.
We agree. All right. And just blowing apart both lines. Wolf through. Lead jammer Philly. Maiden Sane about half a track behind her. So Wolf coming in on a scoring run with skaters on the floor. Meryl Stripper at the back pushing her jammer through as Wolf comes up against a tripod and is able to get 2 of those points and calls it. Lots of confusion at the end of that jam.
Very true. Though, something to point out, Philly's pivot in that jam, Papa Roach, nice offense on the far straightaway there to open that hole, which allowed for the points to be picked off and the jam to be called.
The score, Philly 35, Terminal City 23, 18 minutes and 17 seconds left in the first period. I'm Double H here with Mike Checks.
Kilmartin jamming for Philly opposite Moulin Bruise.
Kilmartin right through the inside. Lead jammer, Philly. Moulin Bruise getting her space taken away by three blockers and now four as Michelle Castro comes out of the penalty box and hops forward to play some offense for her jammer. Scoring points at turn one is Kilmartin. Kilmartin's going to call it.
That'll run Kilmartin's point total to 18 and Philly's point total to 40 as they extend their lead now to 17. 17 minutes, 37 seconds left in the first half. And we would like to thank 888, protecting Derby since day one. You can find out more at 888.com.
And here's Kim Janna facing off against Herman Monster.
Kim Janna, the only jammer for Terminal City, which has picked up lead, has done so in two out of the three jams that she's skated thus far.
And now she's getting recycled to the outside and receiving a penalty. Mike Checks, it is going to be a forearm penalty. So now Herman Monster, lead jammer on a power jam.
Not exactly what Terminal City wanted to see at this juncture, down 17.
Herman Monster grabbing 5 points. And two penalties being assessed to Philly. That's Little Loca and Teflon Donna headed to the penalty box. So now a 4-2 pack advantage in this power jam for Terminal City as Herman Monster approaches turn four, ready to score points.
Terminal City needs to ratchet down the defense and really kill the remainder of this penalty, which they do. Nicely done, moving Philly's jammer to the outside.
The pack now at the pivot line as Herman Monster approaches and gets recycled to the outside. Kim Janna out of the penalty box.
Nice inverse offense from Sundown. Number 11-11 at the front of the pack from Terminal City, freeing Kim Janna.
Herman Monster trying to grab a few more points before calling it off. And she will get a few more. That's going to be three more. So an 8-0 jam in Philly's favor.
That extends their lead now to 25 as we are under 16 minutes left to play in the first half. Drago out to the jam line for Terminal City. Opposite Wolf. Philly now with four lead jams in a row. Terminal held scoreless for the last five.
Philly taking the back line here. Right through the inside is Wolf, but she is shut down. She is looking for some more room as she approaches the jammer line with speed. She threw around the outside, back to the pivot line, and nicely recycled here on the outside. She is not lead. Drago is lead, and Wolf removes her helmet cover.
Nice lockdown defense by Terminal City, specifically Bloodbath and Green Machine at the front that helped keep Wolf in the pack on this initial pass.
And Wolf is pushing forward. Her pivot is Devoid of Mercy, who's now playing defense and is going to get a penalty. Going to the penalty box, so Wolf has the star in her hand, but it will not be able to initiate a star pass, Mike Checks.
And got moved to the inside there. Big hit. Terminal City rolls through for another five, but are losing a blocker in the process. That's Scarlet Bloodbath.
So we are 3-on-3 in the pack here. Well, I apologize. Now we're 3-on-2. Terminal City hemorrhaging blockers right now. Philly setting up the tripod at turn one as they force Drago out of bounds. And that is going to be a 7-0 jam in Terminal City's favor.
Inkshot, the latest Terminal City blocker to find herself in the Pabst Canada penalty box. Philly now with a 19-point lead, 49-30 inside. 14 and a half minutes left in the first half.
A pack advantage here for Philly, 3-2, with Kilmartin on the line and Maiden Sane. So a three-person brace at the back holding Maiden Sane back. Kilmartin recycled past the jammer line by these two awesome blockers from Terminal City. Pushing forward past the pivot line, she's able to get lead jammer status for Philly.
Now, Griffith and Palmer did a nice job holding back Kilmartin. Once they gave up lead jammer, went back, immediately started playing offense and got their jammer out very quickly.
Kilmartin on that scoring pass. Ooh, is going to be taken to the infield. That was
Griffith.
Griffith,
yeah.
Number 42. And is she going to get a cutting the track call on that last one? Yeah.
That's what we're looking for right
there. That is exactly what I think I might have reviewed. You've got 13 minutes left in the first period. Why not?
Yep. And there we see. We saw the O coming up from Terminal City's coach. He is going to ask for the official review. Now, the question is, you and I, from our vantage point, were able to see that track cut. Did any of the referees?
The Ballad of Double H, all tournament season long.
Well,
I've had a front row seat to many a thing, Mike checks, but certainly from our vantage point, and I know Terminal City also had a similar vantage point, that they went down and her foot completely spun around that inside boundary and back onto the track. So, yes. And well, the question now, though, is whether it happened before the call-off, as the call-off was happening, and they may not be able to determine.
No, you're very right. The timing of that is going to be questionable. You see Duncan Disorderly listening to the official review, and while we have a moment, we'd like to thank Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the 2016 WFTDA Tournament MVPs. Thank you, Fast Skates. Fast Girl Skates, specifically.
I knew what you meant. Okay, we're going to hear about this official review that I think we know what it is.
Terminal City are requesting an official review on the lack of a cutting call on the Philadelphia Jammer at the end of the jam.
So well said. So much better than I said it. Yeah.
Just a little more succinct, really. I mean, that's all.
Yeah, maybe slightly classier.
Well,
probably.
Yeah,
anybody's going to say it classier than me.
Well.
But I think it's really going to come down to what we were talking about, whether or not they think that the fourth whistle had blown before that happened. And I think the timing was just dangerously close.
It was really close, but as we saw the action unfold, I know that both of us thought,
slow motion. No.
One of the few times that we're actually in a good vantage point to see something like that happen.
And we do have some determination. We're going to find out in a moment what that determination is.
That's right. Duncan Disorderly calling in both coaches. Teflon Donna in on the conversation as well.
Twitter Scream Queen says, remember when Philly had dresses? Yes, I do. I do remember.
Yeah.
Blue dresses and black dresses.
That's right. Had to have both.
Twitter also asking, is the name Drago or Drago? We have asked, Mike checks.
Yes, it is Drago, according to two of the Terminal City skaters.
Hopefully they know.
Well, I tried to exercise due diligence.
The no call will stand. The Philadelphia Jammer had not fully re-entered the track by the end of the first set of four whistles. Terminal City do not retain their official review.
You know what? It was a great shot. It was a good shot. I would have taken it too.
It was, but as we've talked about off camera, one of the hardest things to do is get a non-call changed to a call.
It's difficult. Because if it's not seen
often
in the moment, it's really tough to go back and convince someone that they've seen it. Off the start line, we have Herman Monster and Moulin Brews. Herman Monster pushing forward all the way to turn two, and there are going to be some calls assessed. Perhaps an out-of-play call assessed here to one of the blockers from Terminal City as Herman Monster gets through to become lead jammer.
Green Machine to the
Green
penalty
machine.
Box for Terminal City. Number 19, 15 to the penalty box. Zip block for Philly. Going to be joined by number 47, Scarlet Bloodbath from Terminal City. Everybody loves the Pabst Canada penalty box.
On the far straightaway, the pack strung out between turns two and three. Herman Monster breaking through a two wall to grab more points. Checks with their bench. They say call it for four more. And that is going to be a 9-0 jam in Philly's favor.
I understand you're down to two blockers on the track, but for Terminal City there, that was an easy scoring pass that they gave up, allowing the jammer to essentially split the defense right between the two of them. You've got to be more together if you're the only two blockers on the track.
And you know what? I think being two blockers on the track is sometimes even scarier than being one blocker on the track, because then you could completely split and go the wrong way. At least if it's you, you have one person to blame.
Well, and when there's two of you, twice as much is expected of the two of you as opposed to where there are only one.
Exactly. All right, Wolf and Kim Janna. Kim Janna fighting a tripod Wolf through to become lead jammer on the outside. I think her opponents thought she might have been either out of bounds or down, and she just got right back up and into it, right around the outside. Is she going to? That was dangerously close to the line. Mike checks on the outside, but no call there.
Philly losing their pivot to a penalty.
That is Little Loca headed to the penalty box. Wolf recycled all the way back to turn one. And that is Palmer doing the recycling from terminal.
Now, Palmer got the actual recycle there. Tried to get it before, but there was no cut. She drew herself back, but did not bring a jammer with her.
And that was a star pass to Scarlet Bloodbath at the end of that jam. No points for Terminal City, but 5 for Philly.
65-30, our score in favor of Philly. Just 11 minutes left to go in this first half of play. Your lead jammers favoring Philly heavily right now. In the 14 jams that have gone by, they have held lead 11 times. Terminal City only 3. They are hoping to change that in this next jam as they send out Maiden Sane to take on Kill Martin.
And a pack advantage goes to Terminal City. Only 2 blockers on the line, but they are Kill Martin and Russian Bayou. I'm sorry, they are Russian Bayou and Castro. Kill Martin is jamming. And she is pushing forward at turn one, but right around the outside. Number 88, Maiden Sane for Terminal City, lead jammer.
Blocker differential finally favoring Terminal City there, and they were able to take advantage of it.
And she is able to score 5 points for her team. Kill Martin still working around the outside line, trying to get some space. And she's recycled all the way back by Scarlet Bloodbath.
Nice job by Russian Bayou to cut that recycle short for Philly.
Oh, and a big hit from Russian Bayou to open up a hole for her jammer. Kill Martin able to get through. She's now eyeing up a scoring run, but she's going to the penalty box instead.
Heard a late whistle, did not see a call that accompanied it, but the result, power jam Terminal City.
So I think Philly's pack a little bit confused by that as well. They're recycling here. On the pivot line, Maiden Sane coming to a tripod, coming and in to provide some offense. Here is their pivot, Scarlet Bloodbath.
I just wanted to point out how low Zip Block was getting in that tripod formation. Almost impossible to block against at that point.
The far straightaway, Kill Martin out of the penalty box.
Bruiseberry Pie to the penalty box for Terminal City.
I believe she made her initial, but we're going to have to see. There's a low block penalty being assessed in the pack.
That's going to go against Green Machine for Terminal City.
And Terminal City doing a tremendous job recycling Kill Martin, and there were no points scored there on that side. So a 15-0 jam in Terminal City's favor brings this game, 18-0 jam. Brings this to under 20.
For Terminal City, they effectively cut Philly's lead in half in that jam. Now find themselves trailing only 17 with 8.5 minutes to go. Philly 65, Terminal 48. That is number 22, Mulan Brews, taking the line once again for Terminal City opposite Herman Monster.
So Philly taking the back with a tripod, pushing forward. Is Herman Monster? Her sister, Ginger Vita, is providing a hit of offense, but she didn't seem to touch those two blockers up front for Terminal much before getting through. Herman Monster, one to beat. It's number 42, I believe that's Griffith.
You're absolutely right. Philly able to take advantage of the discrepancy in blocker numbers. No, a track cut penalty assessed to Mulan Brews. Power jam Philly.
So this is the third penalty for Terminal City's jammers in this period. And now Philly on a power jam as two of their blockers spring forward. The tripod from Terminal City back at the jammer line holding Herman Monster. Now she's got two to beat. Great recycling at the front here from Terminal City.
Nice job by Philly not going passive with the offense, instead keeping a goat in the backfield. That number 131, Bruiseberry Pie.
And they continue to do so with a four-person formation at turn four. Herman Monster approaching the jammer line once more and a tripod of Terminal City blockers that she pushes forward and just skips past on the inside.
Ginger Vitus was dropping the bridge, keeping both parts of the pack in play.
And now Moulin Bruise able to make it through. That was her initial. Herman Monster coming around to the far straightaway. The pack speeding up towards turn three.
Herman Monster taking a whip, still having a hard time catching up with the pack. Terminal City doing a nice job setting the pace right now.
Teflon Donna creating a goat in the back with Bruiseberry Pie. Nice hit to the infield is going to yield 24 points for Herman Monster. Terminal City nothing in that last jam.
That's got to be a little disheartening if you're Terminal City or a Terminal City fan. They more than halved Philly's lead in the prior jam, thinking that they were back within striking distance, and then Philly responds with a humongous 24-0 jam. Puts them up 41 with 6 minutes left to play in the first half.
You might almost say this game is competitive, Mike Checks.
I might almost say that.
Exciting and competitive.
That I will definitely say.
Kim Janna, I know, is competitive as she's looking for room on the outside, and she is quickly shut down by a tripod of Philly blockers at turn two. But Wolf, lead jammer for Philly. On the far straightaway, the pack extends and continues to speed up. So Wolf coming into a fast pack on the near straightaway. And Little Loca creating a point at the back.
Ziplock to the penalty box for Philly.
So it's going to be 2 points before a call off. So the score now, Philly 91, Terminal City 48, 5 minutes and 18 seconds left.
We would like to thank Adam Skates. Color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates. Find out more at adamskates.com.
And although it is not a team timeout, apparently the rollergirl.ca logo is saying hello anyway.
It does that from time to time.
Kilmartin jamming against Maiden Sane. Maiden Sane through to become lead jammer right on the inside. Kilmartin being kept at bay nicely here by Terminal City. A four-person cube here has been torn apart. Kilmartin pushing forward. Right through the inside, though. Maiden Sane on a scoring run, 5-point pass.
Philly down to two blockers on the track right now. Now back to three. Pardon me, but great offense coming from Sundown on both the initial and the first scoring pass.
Kilmartin recycled to the outfield, is going to take off her helmet, and she's going to motion to the pivot, Ginger Vitus. We'll see if that continues. Maiden Sane pushing forward, Ziplock taking her to the infield. And Kilmartin has some communication with Ginger Vitus, who now has the star, so there has been a successful star pass.
Palmer out front trying to keep her in the pack to no avail. Clear on the initial for Philly.
So coming in on a scoring pass is Ginger Vitus with the call-off from Maiden Sane. Maiden Sane happy with that one. That's another 5-point pass, a 10-0 jam in favor of Terminal City.
For Maiden Sane, the leading scorer for Terminal City, she has 31 points to her credit. Opposite side of the ledger, leading scorer for Philly, Herman Monster with 55. Drago out to the line for Terminal City. Opposite Herman Monster.
So coming around to look for an offensive opportunity is Scarlet Bloodbath. And she's the pivot for Terminal City. Not able to help as much as she'd like, but her jammer, Drago's got two to beat, and she is through to become lead jammer for Terminal City.
Multiplayer block whistled down in turn two. That helped free her, and you heard the roar from the crowd of approval as number 80 Papa Roach reports to the penalty box for Philly.
Drago through the inside. That's going to be a 4-point pass for Terminal City. Herman Monster also roughly 10 feet behind the pack. She's going to hit the pack, and Drago's going to let her, even though Drago is the lead jammer, also coming in on a scoring run.
Terminal City taking advantage of the blocker discrepancy as they did earlier this bout. We pointed that out, that we liked that they were going to push the pace. Again, trusting in their blockers, trusting the discrepancy in the blocker numbers, paying off for Terminal right now.
It's paying off for Terminal really well, and Scarlet Bloodbath's offense is also paying off really well for Drago. Herman Monster is content to take it slow, and she's pushing against that tripod at turn one. She doesn't really have the opportunity for much offense, but coming out of the penalty box is Little Loka, the pivot, who's going to try to open some holes before dropping back to play defense. And now Little Loka's going to get a call for that, and she held her hands up and said, why though?
3 points picked up by each jammer in that last scoring pass for our total in that jam, Terminal City 11, Philly 3. Minute 40 left in the first half. Philly with a 94-69 lead.
And it's going to be an official review, Philly.
So both teams using their official review in the first half. While we are listening, while head referee is listening to the official review, we would like to thank S1 Helmets. Did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for roller derby too?
I did not.
Make S1 part of your uniform. You can do so at S1helmets.com.
I was being dramatic. I did know.
Well, that's because you've worked a tournament.
I've been doing this
once
for
twice.
A couple of weeks.
Oh my gosh.
Let's take a look at some penalties.
Shall
checks.
We?
So I know that Philly, regardless of whether or not they have something to review here, they've got some serious penalty trouble from blockers.
Yeah.
Four penalties for Castro, four for Ziplock, five for Little Loka, and these are three of the heavy rotation blockers that they have going on right now. So this is a good time to rest, everybody. Take a breath. Little Loka is the pivot right now, and she is in the penalty box. I do wonder if they're going to argue her penalty. I believe it was a direction of gameplay. No, an out of play. Maybe it could have been a distraction because she is the pivot.
That is a possibility.
Philly are requesting an official review on the destroying the pack call made on the black blocker. Philly feels that the call should have been made on the red blocker instead.
All right, then.
So you've done this before.
I should just go out there and work directly. Actually, no, we should. Duncan and I can change positions. No, I think, obviously, Little Loka is, has worked in games in the Wftda, and so I know she knows penalties. So I'm sure it's not like she hasn't committed five of them. But a 2-in-1 jam, I think, is the moment where she probably would be looking to fight something like that. And it's a good opportunity for them to do it. They've got a minute and 34 left on the clock in the first period. Why not?
You don't get to carry it over to the second half, so if you've got it, you might as well use it.
Some of our friends on Twitter are also pointing out the lovely national pride that both of these teams are showing between the Canadian Maple Leaf Pants and Nikki Cash, the bench manager for Philly's Stars and Stripes, her unitard.
True.
It's exciting. People like to see it.
Before we get to the decision on this official review, our penalty count currently, by my count, sits at 20 for Philly, 15 for Terminal City. And we will kick it down to Duncan Disorderly.
The destroying the pack penalty for the Philly blocker will stand. Philly has used their official review for this period.
Okay.
So concise.
Yes. So the score, Philly 94, Terminal 70. We've got a minute and 34 left on the period clock.
And more importantly, we have two teams with no official review left in this half. 12:23, Kim Janna out to jam for Terminal City, opposite Wolf for Philly.
Kim Janna tries to jump the straightaway on the outside and is not successful. Wolf is able to get lead jammer status for Philly. And pushing forward, Kim Janna still not through and is able to get taken down by Russian Bayou. Will that be a low block?
I couldn't actually discern the hand signal. I don't know if that was a misconduct or a low block, but either way, result the same. Russian Bayou to the penalty box.
That is going to be a low block, Mike checks.
That made the most sense, but I couldn't quite tell that far away.
It did. Philly 96, Terminal City 70, 52 seconds left in the first period.
Maiden Sane returns to the jam line for Terminal City. 31 points so far this bout. Opposite Kill Martin, 20 to her credit.
And there's going to be a team timeout from Terminal City. Our team timeouts are brought to us by our friends at rollergirl.ca.
Interesting time for a team timeout here. We've got less than 40 seconds in the half. This is Terminal City's first team timeout. In your experience, what's Terminal City looking to gain here?
I think that they... So the Philly has two blockers in the box, and Terminal has three blockers on the track, right?
I'm
looking to see. Okay. So it's another potential pack advantage for them to be able to start in this way. And if they want to get another jam out of this, which, you know, they absolutely can, they've got the ability to do that. So I really think what they're trying to do is squeeze some more points out of this period with the score 96-70.
Okay, I'll totally buy that part, that they are going to try and use this blocker advantage to their advantage. And so maybe this was a breather for some of their blockers and skaters that they wanted to send out specifically in this situation. But I have a harder time believing they're doing this to get two jams in before the break because they've got one in the box right now and one of the two Philly blockers currently standing, indicating that she's got less than 10
seconds.
She
does have less than 10 seconds. And I was going to say their blocker is not standing.
Right.
I agree with that. They did have questions in the infield. And that was much longer than 30 seconds. So it might have been that they were awarded that team timeout also. And so through to become lead jammer, Maiden Sane. Right after her, though, about 10 feet is Kilmartin, who's going to get a cutting the track penalty. I don't know, Mike Checks. We'll see how much time Terminal City can scrape out of this one. So coming in on a scoring run is Maiden Sane, who's got three to beat and now two. Pushing forward, a little bit of offense from her pivot Sundown. Maiden Sane finds some room on the inside.
Blocker advantage had been negated, and now the two remaining blockers, one for each team, exiting the penalty box, rejoining play on the track.
And so now the period clock has ended, so they can't even call a timeout if they want to call this jam off and try to get another jam in. So in on a scoring run, back at the jammer line is Maiden Sane, who's 5 points into this jam already. Kilmartin, out of the penalty box, is also pushing forward on the near straightaway, and she finds a little bit of room on the inside, but is still hung up behind two blockers, now one to beat. She threw for her initial.
Was inches away from getting another track cut penalty assessed there. Did manage to drop her toe stops inbounds. Terminal City calls off the jam, having picked up only five, but that's all right, because that means they've cut Philly's lead down to 16, 10 points total in that jam. Double H, we're going to go to halftime with a score. Philly 96, Terminal 80.
And you know what? You know what, Mike Checks? Coach Dad had as many questions as you did about that last time out.
All right.
That Terminal City was taking. So I guess it makes us feel a little bit better about our timeout usage.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe they could have gotten another jam in if they had been a little bit more strategic, if that's what they wanted to do. They didn't need to burn timeouts, crazy thing.
That was my question is with
why,
that
though?
Little time left in the first half, why did you choose to take the timeout? Now, I honestly hope this is not something that comes back to bite them in the second half, but 30 minutes will tell.
30 minutes will tell, and
that's
we'll take a few more to thank some of our sponsors.
We'll
be back after this to see the second half of Philly versus Terminal City live on WFTDA.tv. Welcome back to the 2016 WFTDA International Division I Playoffs live from Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. And you missed Raucous Ron and musical knee pads.
I am so glad that you brought that up. Fans, if you haven't made it to a tournament in the last year or so, you owe it to yourself to come out to one of these. Raucous Ron just led a number of contestants in musical stinky knee pads. I'm glad I'm not any closer to the track than I am right here, but... really, fun was had by all down there.
Yeah, and if you want to catch it, go to the WFTDA Facebook page, because we did it live.
That's right.
That was Taco
Cat,
our resident Facebook liver, who was catching all the action. But speaking of the action, let's talk a little bit about it in the first period.
Yeah, we're going to talk about some numbers real quick. Leading all scorers for both teams, Herman Monster, 58 points in 7 jams. That is an average of over 8 points per jam, and doing this with nay a penalty. Nicely done
not
in the first half.
Not too shabby.
Rounding out Philly scoring 20 points in 8 jams for Kilmartin. That is less than 1 point per jam. Also picked up 2 penalties during that time. And Wolf, 18 points in 7 jams. It's about 2.5 points per jam. Also no penalties for her. For the team altogether, 22 penalties for Philly in the first half. On the opposite side of the ledger for Terminal City, Maiden Sane, leading Terminal City scores 41 points in 7 jams, an average of just shy of 6, also done with 0 points. Kim Jana, 20 points in 6 for an average of 3.3, 1 penalty for her. And Drago, 19 points in 3, no penalties for an average of over 6. 16 total penalties for Terminal City in the first half.
And so for the 22 total penalties for Philly, 13 of those are going to go to 3 of their biggest blockers, Castro and Little Loca and Ziplock. So,
and for Terminal City, Green Machine has been involved a lot playing offense, mm-hmm. playing defense, has basically been all over the track. And you know what? If you're doing dirty work, you're probably picking up penalties to go with it. She seems to be doing the work that nobody else wants to do out there. Her penalty count shows it, but you know what? You've got to have somebody like that on your team.
That is so accurate. You need that hard hitter on your team, especially if it's someone who's helping you to play offense.
Somebody who's willing to do the dirty work, the stuff that you're not necessarily going to get credit for, the stuff that's not going to show up on the stat sheets. I mean, you know, basically what Dennis Rodman did, making a whole career out of being the person who wants to do the stuff that nobody else does. And I wasn't just referring to the hair colors.
I was going to say that I think that we're just as colorful and outlandish as Dennis Rodman, but
that is true. We're about ready to get the second half underway, and looks like we're going to start things with Maiden Sane jamming for Terminal City and Herman Monster for Philly.
Philly taking the back line, trusting that tripod in the back to capture Maiden Sane. Ginger Vitus, the pivot, actually both pivots now in the middle trying to bridge, but Herman Monster drawn back. Is she going to get that cutting call? No. That is a penalty being assessed to Palmer.
Actually, blocking out of bounds. Yeah, no, blocking out of bounds the first. It looked like I did not catch the second. Herman Monster out with lead for Philly.
And she is on a scoring run now, coming to turn two, and now on the far straightaway. In front of her is Maiden Sane. Monster looks at the bench and says, "What should I do?" And they say, "Call it for 4." So Philly now at 100, Terminal City 80.
On a situation like that where the opposing jammer is in front of you after you've completed a scoring pass, of course, it's normal to want to call off the jam. But also, they have a 4-2 blocker advantage to start this next jam now. So benefits them on multiple levels having called that jam off. Then we've got Kim Jana lining up on the jam line for Terminal City opposite Wolf for Philly.
Pack advantage here for Philly, 4-2. Wolf has 2 to beat at the front. She ducks around on the outside and is lead jammer. And now she comes around back to eye up the back of the pack. Kim Jana looking to pass the star that ends up on Russian Bayou's knees. Looking for Scarlet Bloodbath, though. Not able to find her. And now Scarlet Bloodbath trying to play some offense as Wolf comes around on another scoring pass.
Wolf just torched the track between the initial pass and all the way through her first scoring pass. I mean, those were like 8-second laps.
Kim Jana finally able to make it through, and now coming in on another scoring run is Wolf right through the middle. Spun around. And that's going to be a 14-0 jam in favor of Philly.
Wow. I don't really have much more than that. That was some very fancy footwork being shown off there. Kilmartin taking the star in the next jam for Philly opposite Drago.
And you know, Sundown already setting up on the inside line to try to play some O for her jammer.
Blocker advantage favoring Terminal City.
So Philly pulling back to try to trap the jammer, not able to do it. Drago on the outside. I love the way that offense just collapsed around the tripod of Philly. Terminal City doing a nice job with that. And Kilmartin able to make a run for it. She's through on her initial. Drago scoring points at turn 2. Looks to her offense to clear line on the inside, but Ginger Vitus and Castro are there. Is she going to get their points? She is going to get three. So a 3-0 jam for Terminal City, bringing them to 83, Philly 114.
Terminal City's coach out talking to the referees, wanted all five. Oddly enough, I don't think that argument's probably going to get him the extra 2 points.
That never works.
It really doesn't.
Excuse me, sir. Could you actually add three? No, you don't want to? Okay. Never works.
I guess you can't find that out until you try, though.
Unless you're V-Diva, and then sometimes it works.
I'm sure that is true as well. Maiden Scene wearing the star for Terminal City this jam opposite Herman Monster.
And Herman Monster taken all the way to the outside line, but does not cross it on turn one. She's coming through now. And finishing her initial, or trying to finish her initial, is Maiden Sane, who's also getting taken to the outside. Pushing forward is Herman Monster.
Nice job by Russian Bayou, finishing her hits, making sure that Maiden Sane exited the track area.
And now through for her initial is Maiden Sane. Herman Monster, getting drawn all the way back to turn one, is going to prefer to call it. And she will get a few points for her trouble. That's four.
That moves Philly's score to 118, Terminal City 83, just under 26 minutes left in this game.
You know, both of these teams have just done such a good job at trying to transition between O and D, but then reform. And these teams are breaking each other to bits. They're breaking their formations apart really nicely. And here it happens again. Ginger Vitus tries to open a hole on the outside for her jammer, Wolf. Continues to work on it. Wolf taken to the outfield at turn one. Kim Janna has one to beat on the inside line, and it's also Ginger Vitus. And now a tripod has recaptured Kim Janna.
Philly losing devoid of mercy to the penalty box as Kim Janna through the pack lead jammer Terminal City.
And that was some beautiful offense from Sundown to open some holes for her jammer, Kim Janna.
And now you see Sundown anchoring the defense out there in the front of the pack and gets the exit hit on Wolf.
But a back block sending Kim Janna to the penalty box. So now Ginger Vitus wearing the star for Philly as the pivot who received the star from Wolf, and she is pushing forward. Philly trying to play some O and slow the pack down a little. They're able to try to run Sundown. It did not work.
That was a poor choice.
So Wolf now popping forward to play offense. The pack at turn one. Ginger Vitus is on a scoring run, so she is looking for some room. She's looking for hips to pass.
And this is where we've seen Terminal City at some of their best, killing penalties as they did right there. Kim Janna already out of the penalty box, back on the track.
And now she is being stopped by a tripod, but a nice kill here. The pack's so strung out, Mike checks, and there's some beautiful bridge work that's being done, but the packs have been torn apart.
No, and Eve Hall is headed to the penalty box. Out of play penalty, essentially.
Ginger Vitus recycled to the outside, and she is pushing forward. And penalties being assessed. That's another to devoid of mercy.
Second this jam, I believe.
So that is going to be two track cuts in this jam for her.
Yeah.
And now the jam comes to a conclusion. And that is going to be a score of 3-0 in favor of Terminal. So Philly did not actually break the pack there on
no.
that one.
Terminal City cutting Philly's lead to 32 now, 118 to 86 as we approach 23 minutes left in this game. Herman Monster back out to the jam line for the Philly Roller Girls. Opposite Drago, who's wearing the star for Terminal City.
3-on-3 for blockers in this pack. Herman Monster and Drago pushing forward, the pack finally reaching the pivot line. Herman Monster trying to continue pushing it forward. She beats Scarlet Bloodbath and gets through to become lead.
Ink shot to the penalty box on a multiplayer block. Number 31, Eve Hollows out and rejoining action on the track for Terminal City.
Drago able to make it through. Herman Monster finds some room on the inside, looks at her bench. They say call it, and she'll do it for 4 points. So Philly 122, Terminal 86, 22 minutes and 18 seconds left in the game. And math, Mike checks.
I
math.
Know.
There's so much math in front of us.
All the math right now.
When your teacher says, is math worthwhile? Yes, it is.
Keeping hand stats, darn right. That is Kill Martin out on the jam line for Philly, opposite Maiden Sane for Terminal City. Maiden Sane with some jammer defense to start. Kill Martin went down and Maiden Sane went right over top of her.
Yeah, and that is going to send her to the penalty box. Kill Martin slow to get up on that one, but now down blockers are both of these teams. So we've got Kill Martin coming forward, still yet to break the pack. Philly's blockers push forward on the infield, try to get some space, but nice job from Little Loka clearing a path there. Kill Martin has one to beat. She's going to do it on the inside for lead jammer status, but that is Palmer. Number 16 Palmer, who's escorting herself off the track for an injury.
Medics are in the ref lane. That's not something you see terribly often right now, but she's being tended to and now being moved off the track.
And she is slowly standing.
And skating back to her bench area. I believe it's the left leg that she's favoring there. She's skating back to Terminal City's bench.
Still some conversation on points, and there's going to be an official timeout. I wonder if they're going to have a question also about that pileup between Kill Martin.
I'm curious.
Maiden Sane.
Yeah, I'm curious if Terminal City's coach is out to calmly discuss points, penalties, or lack thereof. Honestly, could have a number of issues.
Yeah, in any event, I would be definitely right there in the middle of the track.
Well, and you see that the referees are having a conference before even going over to address either of the coaches.
There could also be some conversation about the injury, but
that's true.
Let's thank some of our sponsors.
That's right. We'd like to thank Quick, part of the Rydell family. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings when precision meets performance.
Taking a look at some penalties. Little Loka frozen at 5. Meryl Stripper, no penalties, but below her, Michelle Castro also has 5. But as you pointed out, there were 2 cutting the track penalties that we saw from Devoida Mercy in one jam. She's got 3 total in this game. For Terminal City, Green Machine also sitting at 4 penalties, Inkshot at 3. And Mike checks, we had taken a look in the first period, and there were, I'm going to say, 80% of the skaters for Terminal City had one penalty.
Yep.
And now a good number of those have 2 penalties.
Didn't take long.
Did not take very long. So on each side, penalties mounting, but specifically for Philly, Little Loka, and Michelle Castro in the most penalty trouble there.
So Duncan Disorder done conferring with the other referees in the middle of the track, now coming over and hearing the case of Terminal City's coach.
So I'm also wondering if points did not go on the board because perhaps there's some question about whether or not they thought Kill Martin had created the penalty instead and whether or not she should have scored points, but we'll take a look.
Plenty of things to speculate about this time.
We could speculate for days, Mike checks.
Really could.
Twitter also speculating. Some folks reaching out and saying that Kill Martin's leg angle on that fall, making me not feel so good, says Hardcore Lena. And we are going to have an official review that is coming from
Terminal City.
Terminal City. So it is a rollergirl.ca.
That's right. Team timeout. Or excuse me. Official review brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience the Canadian dollar, rollergirl.ca.
I love the Canadian dollar, Mike checks. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, right now you do.
I love it.
It's because the exchange rate's great for you. Okay.
Yes, I love it.
I like the artwork. I like the spocking the tens.
It's good stuff.
Yeah, that's...
I'm enjoying Canada in general.
No offense to any other place that I visited in a postseason tournament, but I will say this. This is the first city and venue where I'm like, I got to go home when?
Yeah.
I don't want to go home.
It's pretty
lovely. I kind of like it here. If by kind, I mean a lot.
Yeah, it is lovely. And Terminal City has been a lovely host. These league members, aside from the skaters that you're seeing on the track today, They have a goodly number of league members who are doing a tremendous job. They're keeping us fed.
Yeah.
They're keeping us snacked up.
Wonderful tournament hosts have been absolutely great to work with. All right, so I got to ask now. We're less than 10 full minutes into the second half of play.
Yes.
Terminal City burns a questionable timeout with under a minute to go in the first half.
Yes.
And now is going are using their official review. I got to think that he has a case this time because there were so many things.
You're only going to use it right now if you think that you have a case. That has to be it.
Because you're down by 36 points right now, and you have two team timeouts remaining for the last 21 minutes. That's a lot of time.
So there's still some conversation happening, and we'll hopefully learn soon. But yeah, I got to agree. Like, you've definitely got to have what you think is the accurate call if you're going to make that assessment at this point and get in there and review it.
The other thing we got to start talking about now is the stoppage of play nearing almost 5 minutes is which team does this benefit, if either?
That's a great question. And certainly sending skaters back cold is always something you don't want to do.
Always scary.
5 minutes. Let's see.
Terminal City are calling an official review to request a low block call against the Black Jammer.
And that explains a good amount of time that has been used so far. So we're over 5 minutes of stoppage here. Philly, 122. Terminal City, 86. There's 20 minutes and 49 seconds left in the game. I am Double H here with Mike Checks, and you are watching the 2016 International Division One Playoffs live from Vancouver, British Columbia in Canada. And you're emptying out your wallet. Are you about to give me your credit cards? Because
no,
this is going to be the best day ever.
No.
All right.
I'm going to try and pay off the referees to get this game going.
Are you perhaps going to buy a ticket to championships?
I should buy a ticket to championships, but I hope to be working there, actually, because it's going to be held in glorious and cosmopolitan Portland, Oregon.
I know where that is.
You do know where that is.
I do. I've been there before.
We have hosted you before, actually.
Yes, and I'm excited to come back.
Is Catman coming out as well?
Oh, you know, I would love to bring him, and he would absolutely love to come. They are going to be in Portland. You have the ability to buy tickets now. In fact, VIP tickets are on sale right now for only $125. You get the 3-day VIP ticket with reserved seating for the best seats in the house, a collector's program, and a VIP badge and lanyard. Look how excited everyone is to be going.
This is amazing. We've got the Philly Liberty Bell and two T-Rexes?
Suicide Hotline.
Okay.
Leading
the wave.
Bells. Yep.
Teamwork.
If anybody's going to do it, it's Sui.
All right. Do it again. Yeah, see, now that the camera's on the wide shot, we can see the entire crowd. They're not going to do it now. It's like, oh, they're watching. We can't do it now.
The venue, though, is gorgeous.
It really
is. We've got some really fun, interesting seating. It's a really high ceiling. As you saw, if you were watching games earlier today, there's a giant bank of windows opposite the jammer line that you can get some nice natural light in. And when it's cloudy, it's probably a lot easier on the skaters' eyes.
Well, that is probably true.
So, again, as we mentioned, championships tickets are available now. I wonder if perhaps one of these teams will be headed to championships. And we shall see. We are also on the second to last D1 playoff.
That's right. One to go.
Next weekend will be in beautiful Madison, Wisconsin, hosted by the Mad Roland Dolls,
where we will put the final pieces of the puzzle together.
Yes, and where I know that there are some Greenbush donuts waiting for me. I do see Wolf warming up on the track, so I am wondering if perhaps that call was not overturned. But we shall see.
Or if the non-call will stand.
The non-call, exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
Again,
yep. Yeah. You know what, though? For something like that, it was a big action.
It was a huge action.
It happened
action.
Right in front of the benches. It's definitely something that I would have challenged. It happened on the line, right? So it requires a little bit of a slowdown.
A low block call is going to be assessed to the Philly jammer in that previous jam based on the contact before the charging call.
So no points.
Wow.
So Philly is getting that low block, and Terminal City will retain their review, Mike checks.
And you know what? I will tip my cap to Terminal City that, like you said, there were a number of things that were questionable that happened specifically at the beginning of that jam. Dicey official review pays off.
So jamming for Terminal now again is Maiden Sane, who is lead jammer. So Philly now with 4-3 pack advantage, but they are on a power jam. Maiden Sane completing her initial, coming forward her blockers to offer some offense. They do so quickly, but Philly recycling Maiden Sane on the outside as Kill Martin comes out of the penalty box.
Nice job by Flower Plowher to shut the door on Philly's jammer. She was exiting the penalty box, switched over to the outside rail. Nice job.
So Kill Martin getting a cutting the track call on the inside, offering another opportunity for Maiden Sane and Terminal City.
That's right. Crowd responding in kind, probably the loudest we've heard them be so far this evening.
So Maiden Sane on a scoring run has one to beat. It's Ginger Vitus who lets her go and is out of play. Russian Bayou headed to the penalty box holding her knee.
Right, and almost favoring both of her legs on the way there.
So regrouping is Philly's defense as Maiden Sane's offense just waterfalls on the inside. And now we are 10 points into this jam for Terminal. Make that 15. So now a 21-point game.
If a five-minute stoppage in play helped Terminal City find their spark, more power to them because they have come out on fire after that long, long official timeout.
So Kill Martin pushing forward after the Rollergirl.ca team timeout review. And she is around the outside, finally through for her initial. So a huge, huge push here from Terminal City. 18-0 jam in their favor. Philly now 122, Terminal 104.
Again, they halved the lead by Philly. They are now down 18, inside 19 minutes left to play. We saw them do this before, and then they gave up a humongous jam to Philly subsequently. We're going to see what happens now, see if they can capitalize on this momentum.
The jammer to put on there is Herman Monster. She's penalty free so far, and she is pushing forward. Kim Janna, looking for some room on the inside, has Ziploc to beat. And now Herman Monster comes up against a tripod and now a two-person brace, but nice recycling here at the front and extension. From Terminal City, there's going to be a low block assessed to a blocker from Terminal as Herman Monster grabs lead jammer status. That was Bruiseberry Pie headed for her second trip to the box as Herman Monster coming in on a scoring run, but right behind her, Kim Janna. So no points.
Wow, fist in the air for ref solidarity, no score in that one.
Philly 122, Terminal 104, 17 minutes and 38 seconds left in the game.
Well, that is a 24-point better advantage for Terminal City. They did not give up the huge jam after splitting Philly's lead in half. Drago out to the jam line, opposite Wolf.
Full four on the floor, I should say, for Philly.
What in the world?
Wolf just pushing forward, pushed the pack all the way to the far straightaway, and it extended that far, Mike checks.
But she didn't, though. The Terminal City blockers ran out there on their own.
Well, she's pushing forward now on a scoring run.
Oh, nice
job. Her hips around and is going to grab 4 points on that one.
Wow.
Maybe they were just expecting it. Maybe they just said, let's save you some time. We'll run forward. No, that's definitely not what you want. And the floor, I've been told by a lot of the skaters, is actually quite nice and concrete-like.
Oh, really?
It's more grippy than the other sport courts we've had at our other playoffs.
Okay.
So I'm getting feedback from the skaters that they actually really like the court this weekend. Herman Monster, back on the line, has two to beat. She's pushing forward and pushing them almost out of play, and she's going to get that lead jammer status on her toe stops, but no! The outside pack referee corrected the jammer referee. Cutting the track penalty, this is now a power jam made insane. She is not lead.
Not your lead, right.
So we are going to go the full two with an apex jump on the inside. Terminal City fans loving that.
So that gets them back all 4 points that they gave up last jam, plus one.
And so an additional five for Terminal City.
Crowd really getting into this bout now.
Herman Monster standing in the penalty box, made insane, finding the outside line. Ginger Vitus doing the drawback. Pushing forward, Herman Monster getting taken to the outside one more time. Phillies blocker Ginger Vitus, pivot on pivot violence there. Scarlet Bloodbath taking a tumble to the inside. And Herman Monster continuing to score points. Bloodbath headed to the penalty box. An out of play call being assessed in the front, so Herman Monster will make it through her initial. Made insane also on a scoring points. She on a scoring pass, 15. Well, let's make that 19 points in this jam for her so far as Herman Monster comes to the back of the pack. We're within 3 points here, Mike checks.
Gingivitis just completely demolished almost the entire pack playing offense.
So Herman Monster trying to preserve the lead here for Philly, getting recycled to the outfield. Terminal City just 3 points behind, but there are points being scored right now by Made Insane with 4 seconds left in the jam. Herman Monster's got one to beat. And she grabs all 4 points, so that's a 4-4 pass. And now a 23-4 jam has Terminal City within 3 points, Mike checks.
130-127, 14 minutes, 10 seconds left in this second half, and we got ourselves a loud crowd here cheering on the home team. They will send out number 1223, Kim Jana, to the jam line opposite Wolf for Philly.
And Meryl Stripper playing some offense up front for Wolf, who is looking for a line around the outside and finds it to become lead jammer. Kim Jana pushes forward, getting some offense from Palmer. And held at bay at turn two. Wolf moving to the inside, pushes forward, gets some help from Russian Bayou. That's another 5-point pass for Philly, a star pass from Kim Jana to Sundown.
Terminal City trying to pull all the tricks out of the book right now. Got the lead down to three. Philly's going to re-extend it there now. Eight-point scoring.
Yep, I was going to say Wolf grabbed three on that last one. So 138-127, Philly managing to hold on to their lead narrowly, Mike checks.
11-point difference inside, 13 minutes left to play. Drago out to jam for Terminal City. Kilmartin wearing the star for Philly.
Kilmartin with 4 penalties in this game so far.
Both teams at full strength.
Kilmartin looking for a line right up the middle. And a cutting the track being assessed right on the outside to Drago. So this is now a power jam in favor of Kilmartin, who is regrouping after getting hit to the infield. That's Bruiseberry Pie performing some defense against her at the back. And that's also going to be a penalty assessed to number 90.
Green Machine for blocking out of bounds, I believe.
Yeah,
is the call.
And this is it's a cutting the track call.
Oh.
And it is now her 5th penalty as Kilmartin, lead jammer. Ginger Vitus attacking that 2-person wall up front, is able to distract enough to get Kilmartin forward. The out of play call gets her 5 points.
Terminal City gets it close. Philly responds.
Drago, having taken off the star, coming out of the penalty box, sneaks through the pack. Kilmartin turns around and Caesar calls it. That's going to be all of the points there that Kilmartin is scoring in that jam. So a 5-0 jam in Philly's favor. Now 143 Philly, Terminal City 127. Just like that, Mike Checks.
And we've got a team timeout being called by Philly. This team timeout brought to you by Rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Find out more online at Rollergirl.ca.
Yep, and this game right here is a great reason why you want to hold on to your team timeouts.
Yep.
Jex.
Yes, indeed. But like I said earlier, I will tip my cap to Terminal City's coaches there calling that official review. And the team responded in kind coming out of that, again, lengthy timeout review situation. But they are back down 16 now. 143 to 127, 11:31 left to play in the game. Philly still with two team timeouts and an official review. Terminal City also two team timeouts and an official review.
Yeah, Terminal City wants that back line. They want to get right on top of Herman Monster. Made
Scrub
insane.
The acceleration, just like you talked about earlier.
Yep. Made Insane is looking for a little bit of offense. She's pushing forward. Philly reforming. And lead jammer's going to go to Herman Monster. Now all of the blockers from Terminal City dropping back to try to close in on this with a star pass.
That's
Mike
right.
Checks.
Sundown once again, recipient of the star.
Herman Monster scoring points, pushing forward, takes a look behind her to see how far her opponent is, and she's going to call it for three.
The last two jams, Sundown's done a great job being in the right place that she needed to be in order to receive the star pass, and in doing so, limited to the damage that Philly has done in these two jams.
We're going to have Wolf and Kim Janna back on the line. Philly in the back, and that is Scarlet Bloodbath, the pivot, who started right in the middle of that line. Getting taken to the outside is Kim Janna. Wolf right around the outside is going to get lead jammer, trips up.
Where are the Terminal City blockers going?
They were going to try to chase her out, but the out of play warning was right there.
It's good that we have that.
And Wolf right around Kim Janna. He's going to grab 5 points. So a star pass.
Bruiseberry Pie to the penalty box for Terminal City.
Scarlet Bloodbath wearing the star now for Terminal City. Wolf pushing forward, getting some offense from Ginger Vitus as the pack is completely strung out. And Scarlet Bloodbath is going to come to the back of Built to Spill. Wolf pushing forward slowly, 9 minutes and 35 seconds. We're about halfway through 2 minutes.
Pack constricted in turn three.
Wolf getting forced to the inside is gonna slow it down and recycle all the way back. She has no penalties in this game so far, Mike Checks. She does not wanna add to any, so she's pushing forward carefully.
Nice job by Bruiseberry Pie to get the offense that freed Scar, unfortunately, jam called off. 5 more points picked up by Philly, 10-point jam.
Philly 156, Terminal City 127, 8 minutes and 55 seconds left. I am Double H here with Mike Checks. You are watching Philly taking on Terminal City, the 4 and 5 seeds live from Division I playoffs in Vancouver, British Columbia.
Drago on the line for Terminal City, 22 points so far for her. Opposite Herman Monster leading all Philly scorers with 77.
Herman Monster taken to the outside as Drago, taken down by Ziploc, is going to get a cutting the track call. Ziploc celebrating with a little hop skip in the back. Herman Monster pushing forward to try to break up that tripod Terminal City's done such a good job with.
That's right.
Philly with the waterfall offense on the inside, but look at how well Terminal City recycling in the front. They just keep going, Mike Checks.
Forearm to Palmer is going to drop the blocker number for Terminal City down to 3, but they really have excelled at penalty killing.
Yep, and Monster waiting for her offense. She's got one to beat, and it is Sundown. And now just they keep recycling in the front. They've done a good job with that. Herman Monster making it through
Drago out of the box, back onto the track for Terminal City.
So now on a scoring pass, Herman Monster coming to the back, looking for some points to score. She's got 57 seconds left of jam time to play with.
Eve Hollow's getting the exit hit.
And now coming around to score additional points, I know what you were going to say.
Yeah.
Kilmartin headed to the penalty box.
Yep.
That is her fifth penalty. Recycled to the infield. Herman Monster getting dragged all the way back by Sundown. Now through number 17, Drago. Herman Monster getting taken outside. Both of these jammers just slowed down mic checks. I love the way these blockers have just slowed down the gameplay. Everyone stuck at turn one. Herman Monster playing her own offense against Drago, doing the drawback all the way back to turn three. She turns around and takes a look at the clock.
Yep.
And she's got time to play with. She's going to drag this as far as she can as the jam comes to an end. That was a 5-3 jam in Terminal City's favor. All that work for 5 points.
We talk about time management. I was curious why Philly didn't choose to call off the jam there, burn the 30 seconds off the period clock.
Well, Herman Monster had gotten through, but she wasn't signaled lead. That was part of the issue. I had a question about that as
okay.
well. So when she came through, the jammer referee gave her the wave, unlike
okay,
what we're seeing
see
right
them.
Now,
right.
which is that Wolf has lead jammer status for Philly. Made Insane takes a tumble and is able to make it through. Wolf just pirouetting around, takes a look behind her quickly, finds some room on the outside, and is able to get another point or two before she calls it on her back. Both jammers down.
Gingivitis does some great work on the track. Looks like we have an official timeout.
Yeah, we have an injury
we have
timeout.
Two skaters down.
One of them is Made Insane, I believe, who was in 82 points
right.
so far in this game.
Leading
and Herman Monster,
all scorers.
80, yep. So coming off that jam, a 4-0 jam in Philly's favor, 163 now to Terminal City's 132, 5 minutes and 30 seconds left in this game. The Apex on Twitter says Philly has to score and can't just play against the clock here. They might still have one or two jammer penalties coming against them.
Right.
And we do have some jammer penalties, but let's thank some of our friends, Mike Checks.
Well, we'd like to thank Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years. Check them out online at rydellskates.com.
So Kilmartin sitting on 5 penalties, 3 of them in this period alone. Herman Monster, just 1 penalty, and it was in this period as well. And Wolf, no penalties. On behalf of Terminal City, Kim Janna with 2 penalties. We also have Drago with 2 penalties, and Made Insane with only 1 penalty. And this is what that looks like in a visual way.
Lots of ink.
Yep, and of course the black ink is the first period. The blue ink is the second period. So you can see we're almost even in terms of the penalties that have been accrued in each period. So the skaters who were on the track have been removed, mic checks. We always like to see that.
Absolutely right.
But now we come into a game that is 163 Philly, Terminal City 132. Both teams have 2 team timeouts. Both teams have an official review left to spare.
Well, now another official
or
timeout?
Or not.
I heard whistles,
yes.
And I see the official timeout hand signals.
So we are still getting ready. And it looks as though that was Made Insane, who has been brought back to her bench and is being escorted out of the game, perhaps?
No, she hasn't been brought back to her bench. She is actually still down there in the second apex.
Okay.
That's why we have this this second timeout going on.
Okay. And so she has been moved out of the way, and they are cleaning blood off of the track, unfortunately. So once they finish that, we will get back into it. And it sounds as though that's about to happen.
All right, 5 seconds being thrown up by our jam timer there. Kill Martin all lined up behind Kim Janna.
So a 4-3 pack advantage for Terminal City, and it works out in their favor. Kim Janna is lead jammer. About a third of a track behind her is Kill Martin. Terminal City tearing apart Philly's pack. A failed apex jump, and Kim Janna is going to call it, and that's not going to give her, it's going to give her 2 points.
No, she landed it. Yeah.
I would, that would be something that I would review. Let's see if that happens. Perhaps not.
Team timeout being called by Terminal City.
It was a little bit of a tough landing because her skate kind of went down on the inside. But that is, you know, the officials were right there and that is what they saw. So
right. They
saw 2 points. Terminal City 134, Philly 163. You got 2 team timeouts and you got an official review. Do you review that?
At this point, no.
Okay.
No, because...
Even though it's a jammer that you could get the call overturned or a call out of no call.
I still think it's dicey and this bout is close enough still that we've seen some strange things in this game so far.
We have, but you got 2 team timeouts. All right, Mike Chucks plays a conservative. Double
I do
H
play.
Does not.
Yeah, no, I really do.
We have learned that in this game.
You know, I coached with Rob Lobster, so
yeah,
that's part of where that came from.
I know.
Yep.
Good times.
All right, 5 seconds being thrown up once again.
Oh, so there was a terminal team timeout taken there, uh-huh, though, Mike Chucks. So that is going to be burned. So now they've got 1 team timeout left.
And they
have Bazinga and Herman Monster. And Herman Monster is being forced to the outside. She's lead, but Bazinga is through first in front of her in the middle. Herman Monster looks at her team. They're saying, go, go, go. Let's burn some clock. So she comes in. But it is going to be a call off before Bazinga hits the back. And there was some conversation on Herman Monster's bench about why that was happening. But laughs.
Nice timing.
The score remains Philly 163 to Terminal City 135. 4 minutes and 26 seconds left in the game.
Worth pointing out, Michelle Castro currently sitting on 6 penalties for Philly. Green Machine with 5.
Wolf and Kim Janna on the line. A tripod in back from Terminal City. And some offense from Sundown. The pivot allows Kim Janna to get through.
Sundown has been very impressive in taking the star, in playing defense, in playing offense, and a track cut penalty assessed to Wolf. Power jam, Terminal City.
So Philly hopping into the front line, and Sundown trying to rent Ziploc for a moment there. Kim Janna coming into a full complement of Philly blockers, gets a waterfall offense on the inside. Philly shutting it down for the moment. Ziploc doing a good job with the drawback.
Big penalty kill right here for Philly.
As well as Russian Bayou and Meryl Stripper. In the back, Eve Hallows trying to create some holes.
And it was Palmer, actually, who got the credit for the screen there, freeing Kim Janna on that scoring pass.
Wolf racing out of the penalty box with the star in hand. Crashing into the Philly cube is Kim Janna as they escort her to the outfield. Wolf still trying to make some room for herself, pushing against 2 blockers. Ziploc escorting Kim Janna to the outfield at turn 3.
Eve Hall is doing a nice job at defense up front for Terminal City.
A star pass to Meryl Stripper, who is going to put the star on her helmet and being taken to the outside as well by Sundown. So both of these defenses, Mike Chucks, coming down hard.
Big pileup in turn 3, and Kim Janna looking to the inside like, whistles please.
A cutting the track penalty on the infield from Meryl Stripper. is going to send her to the penalty box. And now this is another power jam opportunity for Kim Janna, who does not have time to do anything with it.
Kim Janna getting up after being knocked down in turn four. Second time she'd been knocked down in that apex. Again, gets up and gives a long stare at Biggie Talls, the outside pack ref, before slowly skating back over to the bench area. And honestly, Double H, I don't blame her.
13-point game, Philly 163, Terminal City 150. That was a 15-0 Jam and Terminal's favor. They have taken a rollergirl.ca team timeout.
All right.
Rollergirl.ca.
Team timeout, Canada Skate Shop, experience Canadian customer service. They are rollergirl.ca.
And it just reminds me of the sweet, sweet Canadian dollar, Mike checks.
You saw on your screen there for just a second, Terminal City's coach in front of the jam line talking to Drago, and then the Philly blockers come in and just sort of push him out of the way. I mean, not physically, but.
Yep. So the offense lining up on the out, clearing Green Machine with the pick. Drago, lead jammer, Philly going backwards into turn four. Drago finds some room on the inside, makes it through for a 5-point pass, right past Kilmartin.
No.
Philly trying to reset.
No whistles down in turn four on that initial pass.
Philly resets.
Oh, look at that screen offense on the inside. Nice job by Terminal City.
Philly continuing to reset in the front. And now back on the track is Merrill Stripper, who is going to pass the star to Kilmartin.
Lead down to three right now for Philly.
So a four-person blocking team at the front, trying to keep Drago behind them from Philly. They recycle her and they draw her all the way back. Teflon Donna says, where's my cutting the track penalty? And she will get none. Kilmartin, however, is able to make it through on her initial and she is holding the star.
High block against Scarlet Bloodbath sends her to the penalty box.
And there will be 2 points added. A 1-point game, Philly 163, Terminal City 162, 53 seconds left in the game.
Rollergirl.ca team timeout, Philly Rollergirls.
That's the one you've been waiting for.
Canada Skate Shop, Rollergirls.ca. These Terminal City fans are determined to blow this very beautiful roof right off of this building.
So a huge jam from Terminal City to bring the score within one.
Can I point something out real quick?
Is it the rollergirl.ca
logo? No, it's not that.
Tell me it.
Terminal City has their official review still.
They sure do.
Philly's got one team timeout and one official review.
They sure do.
55 seconds left on the game clock. 1 point separating these teams. Fans at home, I know that you know how these tournaments are set up, but let's remember, whoever loses this doesn't get a shot at championships. Their road to the Hydra ends right here.
4-3 pack advantage, Philly. Ginger Vitus lining up on the pivot line as though it's 2008, but is she set up to make the pick she wants? Herman Monster coming forward, is able to push.
Pack being way spread out.
Kim Janna finds some real estate on the outside. Philly is there. Herman Monster still pushing forward. The pack reassembling back at turn two with the drawback. Both jammers being brought all the way back to the pivot line.
Sometimes you're lucky and you get to be the jammer that was knocked to the inside instead of the outside. That was exactly the case for Kim Janna right there, but
Herman Monster on the inside, lead jammer status, Philly, 16 seconds left in the period. Kim Janna has yet to break the pack. She's got two to beat. Her toe stop lands on the infield. She will get a cutting the track penalty. Herman Monster turns around to look at the clock. Her bench standing, looking. She turns around, is able to call it. Will she preserve the win, Mike checks?
Kim Janna never reported to the penalty box, got assessed the penalty, went in to argue with the jam ref stopped herself short of doing that, but stopped into the center of the track. Jam was called off, just rolled back to her bench.
Pro tip. If you are awarded a penalty, whether or not you think you deserve it, you report immediately to the penalty box unless you feel like you would like to sit for another 30 seconds.
Especially in the final jam. Especially in the final jam. Oh.
I don't know if you are familiar with Philly Roller Derby's history, but they know a thing or two about close games.
Yes, they do.
This is unofficially the final Philly 164, so that would have meant that Herman Monster got an additional point in that last pass. So Philly 164, Terminal City 162. Twitter is freaking out, Mike checks.
Twitter should be freaking out. The roller derby community at large should be freaking out. That was a great bout.
That was a game.
Man, oh man.
So we're going to wait until the final is called.
Let's run through some numbers
penalties.
Real quick.
Yeah.
You want to start with the penalties?
I do. There were no foul outs in this game. Good job,
okay, that
everybody.
Alone is mind-boggling.
High fives.
Oh, it went final now. Your score on the board, legit 164-162. Sorry to interrupt.
No, there are so many things to say.
Right.
No foul outs. Michelle Castro was sitting on 6 penalties. Kilmartin on 5. Ziplock on 5. Little Loca on 5. Green Machine on 5. Everybody had 4 or fewer penalties in the rest of the game. Let's talk about jammers.
Maiden Sane, 82 points, led all scorers, not just for Terminal City, but Philly as well. Rounding out Terminal scoring, 39 for Drago, 41 for Kim Janna. Opposite side of the ledger, leading all Philly scorers, Herman Monster with 81, 58 picked up by Wolf, and 25 added by Kilmartin. And that math means Philly wins by 2.
That math means that Philly advances tomorrow to play VRDL at 2 p.m. on Saturday, and they get to keep their championships hopes alive.
That's right. Forward. Again, it's one of my least favorite things about this 10-team tournament setup is the fact that in these bouts, a 2-point bout, and Terminal City has no shot at advancing now.
But they put on a huge fight here. I'm really impressed with the way they were able to pick off the lines. Philly was able to put in, some offense in key places in their wall. And Terminal City was ready. They were ready for offense, and they executed offense right out of the gate.
No, and again, that's what makes it disheartening about this being a winner gets a chance to advance, loser, tough luck. Especially the fact that it was this close of a game. Tell me that Terminal City couldn't make some noise in a consolation bracket if there was one that would allow you to get further.
I wholeheartedly agree. And you know what? Speaking about noise, I think I see Megatron over there at turn one with the camera with... Could it be the Herman sisters if we're talking about making
bet
some
you're
noise?
Right.
Well, I am Double H here with Mike Checks, and we're going to send it down to our friend Megatron and the Herman sisters.
Hello, I'm Megatron. I'm here with the Herman sisters. Hello, Herman sisters.
Hello.
So you were skating in the last jam. Yeah. You watched the clock. Tell us what was going through your mind when you called that jam off.
I can't believe this happened. Going into the jam, I was like, there has to be a better person to do this.
Now, as we know, the middle bracket, the middle seeds of the bracket, like this first game is always crucial to determine whether you're going to move on or not.
Yeah.
So what did you guys do to prepare for this game specifically?
I'm not shy, Kristen.
I think we just planned that this game could end our season. You know what I mean? Because our weekend would end the entire season if we don't move on to champs, and we're done in September rather than November, which totally blows. So that's our goal. Last year, we ended in September, and her and I were real depressed for a couple of months, and so we want to not do that. That's how we prepared. Yeah. We're anti-depression this year.
Now, you go on to face Wftda. Yes. They were here watching the game. Do you have anything that you would like to say to them pre-game?
Do your worst, Wftda. I don't know. My smack talking needs work. We went and played against them about 2 years ago, and I think that game in particular, like, well, offense should be a thing. So that really, like, sparked a new, like, strategy with us. So.
She had a 2-minute jam where she was up at the front of their pack, and they had 4 blockers, and we had 4 blockers on their jammer, and went the whole 2 minutes without us moving 10 feet. And it was terrifying, and she talks about it still. And so finally we've added offense, so we're a different team.
And we're very excited to play them again.
Yeah.
Excellent. Now, if the seeding works out the way that it looks like, that it might, and Angel City is able to defeat Rat City, and you guys have to face Rat City again.
Yes. Yeah.
How do you feel about that potential for redemption?
I feel like that's what my whole season has been about. I want to play them again, and I want to get the champ spot instead of them.
Yeah, they're awesome, and so we definitely won't underestimate them. If anything, we'll know that we have to be like our best, our very best, in order to meet them, if not beat them.
We watched them today, actually, and they look like a different team, and we're a different team, so we're very excited. Hopefully that happens.
I'm very excited. Congratulations on the win. For all of you guys out there in the internet that are watching, tomorrow is going to be full of amazing derbies, so don't hesitate. Tune in for the first game. We are going to be here live at WFTDA.TV. I'm Megatron with the Herman Sisters. Thank you for watching our broadcast day.
Mom and Dad.